everyone. I would like to give you an update on our DIY of the light controller project. In the meantime, we have already equipped more than 10 cars with our electronics to get the realistic screen lighting. Just as a recap, let me show you the functionality. We have here a very cheap, happy tuned HK810 transmitter. For planetary, it's a simple switch that covers between two positions. By moving the switch one time, we can enable various light functions. Every time we move it, more lights go on. If I move the switch three times, one, two, three, then the lights go off. Three times again, they go on again. If I do four times, then I have hazard lights, and that's how we control it. One, two, three, four. We also have indicators that are representing some kind of selective fuel. What's important about the indicators is that we only engage when we want it to. In order to engage them, the battery and the fuel have to be neutral for a second. So this means if you drive it, then they will not engage, so you don't get the indicators lighting up left and right when you test driving around normally. Only when you want them to, you can engage them. Which makes a very realistic look. Similar on the back, we have our tail lights. When we're driving and driving, then the phone LED lights are brighter, which is a function of the light controller. We also have the indicators again, and we have a reversing light. One new function that we implemented is based on feedback from other people is that the brake lights turn on for a random short interval after you go back to neutral from driving. So you drive, you release, and the brake lights turn on for a short time. And the time is always slightly different for giving the time of a natural organic fuel. That's a very nice function because it makes you just normally driving around makes it very looking. A little bit about the hardware. We changed the hardware to a newer version of the PIC microcontroller. It's the PIC16F1825. All the information will be in the video description. And the light controller PIC also upgraded to a TI TLC5940. The great advantage of the this new chip compared to the 5916 years earlier is that this chip has 16 light outputs compared to 8, which means you can basically drive all the LEDs individually and you don't need a boost converter like you needed in the old version. This chip also has a great advantage that it has a control of the constant current of the LED that you're driving. And you can transfer your software in 64 steps, and that's exactly what you're doing for the tail and brake light and for other things like the light bulbs, the voice. You see that the LEDs are not just on and off, they are actually kind of fading in and out. This is achieved by changing the constant current as opposed to a PWM, because you don't want to have a lot of passage and the signals running around in your radio control vehicle that would cause the distortion. The electronics are still very simple, so as you can see, even a simple breadboard can implement them easily in a small size. But we now also developed a circuit board. The circuit board is, you can order them from OSHPark. Again, that's the video description for a link. The light controller chip on here is a 0.65 millimeter pitch. So it's a very, very fine pitch and it's therefore drives a very good soldering skill. The size of this controller is only 22 × 30 millimeters. It's very small, so it's very, very easy to put anywhere in your vehicle. To implement all the light controller functions, we need to have access to tracker, steering, and the 23 and the receiver. Now, this would mean that you have to have a wire harness between tracker and serial and server, and taking up the signal to go to serial and to go to light controller, and then having an extra wire for the connector. That's a lot of wiring, especially considering that normally the light controller will be mounted in the body while the receiver is mounted on the top. So, unless we have the solution for that, we only use a single cable between the receiver and the light controller. So, you only have to take out one wire to remove the body from the circuit. We do that by adding a tiny microcontroller, which is very inexpensive. It's an 8-pin packet, an SMD packet, which fits in actually basically any receiver that's today on the market that we have seen. We have an early kit for 4 packets for some reasons. And by adding this kit, it basically connects to the channel 1, 2, and 3, and it combines three two signals, and it combines them into a single channel that we output on the battery port, where the signal is actually usually only used anyway. In this way, we get a very clean wiring and very easy to use in the field, for both for parallel and for unwave tasks. So, I hope you liked this update. Check out the link in the description, there's a lot of information. If you're in Singapore, you can always contact us to get some help regarding your lighting. And I hope you can make your own stereotypes look up nicely. Thank you very much.